and I was only part of the presenters there, so I'm now being left to do it all by myself. But this is about a Dumfries and Galloway Employability Award that we've trialled last year and this year. And I'm just going to give you a wee bit of a flavour of how it came about and some feedback from the young people that have been involved in it. The context, a young person in my office helped me with this, so that the technology. The context will be familiar to many of you. We know in Dumfries and Galloway, it's a key sector for our economy, the whole land based, whether it be forestry, agriculture, and lots of the parts of the sector. We have an ageing workforce. We need to recruit young people to help innovate in the businesses, to build in resilience in our local communities and make sure that there's viable opportunities for people. And as Davies just said, the new technology in the industry is huge. So we need able young people to be able to understand what the prospects are and build a bit of experience. So we have, I think, in common across with many schools in Scotland, a number of our schools in Dumfries and Galloway offer the Skills for Work Rural Skills, which is, for those of you that are familiar with the terminology, SQF Level 4. We were then struggling with, well, what do they do next? It's a bit of a big jump to an MA Level 2, and there weren't so many of them about. And not very many of the schools were set up with the expertise to be able to offer the National Progression Award. So there was a bit of a gap there. And George Jameson from the NFU approached me, and he'd been trying for a number of years to get into schools to offer some kind of work experience on dairy farms in particular, and do the Certificate of Work Readiness. But that was difficult because it couldn't be done while the young people were still in schools. At the same time, we developed a Dumfries and Galloway Employability Award, and you'll see the familiar skills around there. These were agreed by employers in Dumfries and Galloway, and they're common to many industries, but there'll be particular ones that are good for the land-based sector. So George and I had a conversation and thought that there was a possible opportunity to do something around this. So I broached the subject with our 16 head teachers, and we got three schools from Dumfries and Galloway that were interested in piloting it, and a couple of head teachers, and SRUC, myself, and some employability and skills people got together in a room to thrash out what we could do. And in the 2016-17, we had six students complete it, a mixture of boys and girls, mixture of males and females, and they were students who stayed, who were at school. Some of them were doing higher, some of them were doing National 5. So they were able young people, but interested in getting a bit more information about the sector. You can see the statistics from yourself. It's been really positive. It's not too easy to see that, but it's not important. But that's just to give you the basic structure of the award that we do. The green units are SQA standard units that a number of schools will do across Scotland, and many of our schools in Dumfries and Galloway do, build up the theory of employability skills, I suppose. There's then the purple ones are out on a work placement. Now that's not necessarily land-based, but it could be any type of work experience. But the key to this is it's extended. It's for roughly a day a week for a whole year of school, and gives them the chance to really get developing skills and applying skills in the workplace. And those are workplace core skills. What was really special about this was the SRUC offered to add a couple of extra units on. So there's a couple of extra units on livestock production and animal care, given the knowledge and the skills to be able to apply that out in the workplace. How it works at the moment is the employability units, the classroom-based ones, are delivered by school, assessed by the school. Around about February, March time, we have promoted this with the schools to find out what interest there is among young people. And over June, July time, we've worked with RET to look at farmers in the area who would be willing to support young people to take a work placement. And then when the youngsters come back to school in August and they've sorted out with their results and their timetable, work out which day of the week would be best. And that's in discussion with the schools and the timetable and the farmers. September this year we did a meet and greet to allow the farmers and the young people to understand what was involved in the award, what sort of evidence were they going to have to collect if they were going to achieve. And now we're in the process that they're out on farms, they're going out a day a week, and we have a tutor in the employability and skills team who goes out to assess them and support them in developing the skills. Throughout the session there are 4 or 5 days where we bring the young people together, either at the barony or hosted at a local farm, to give them the knowledge part that the SRUC are delivering with us. This is one of our students from last year. And this year's cohort, we've increased the number a little, so we have 8 people signed up this year. We've also increased the number of schools involved, so there were only 3, I think, the first year we did it. This year we've got youngsters from 8 different schools across Dumfries and Galloway. And we're thinking about how to extend that work placement, because the work placement could be in any place, in any industry. But we're in talks with SRUC to see if we could offer options that would attach forestry units or horticulture units to that, to give a bit of breadth of experience in a wider areas in the sector. So this year, that's the cohort of this year, have had their first day at the Barony campus, having their introduction with the lecturer and our tutor there with them. And I'm just going to flick through a few slides just to finish, just to give you a flavour of what the young people themselves have been saying about about the award. We think it raises awareness of the sector, so a really good way for young people to get an experience. Word of mouth helped us recruit this year. It was nothing, you know, we didn't have to go and promote this. It was young people themselves hearing from other young people. It gives people a chance to stay in school, which, you know, there's a lot of evidence to say that young people do better if they stay in the system for longer, but this maybe motivates learners who on the other, you know, in previous years would have thought, there's nothing for me at school, I'm going to leave. But this gives them, allows them to do a little bit of both. It allows them, I think, importantly, to do skills, to focus on the skills rather than maybe qualifications. And schools have engaged with this, I think, in a big way because it's so flexible. It allows them to offer a bit of choice to young people, but it fits in with the timetable that already exists. It's also offered alongside hires and National Fives, which for me is really important that we get that parity of esteem, that work-based learning is as valuable and as valued as staying in school to do qualifications. It's start beginning to meet people needs. We've got 6 young people through it, 8 young people through it this year, and more young people already asking if it's going to be on next year too. And just it's increasing, developing young workforce is all about giving a range of opportunities in schools, and I think this has really worked for us in Dumfries and Galloway because it's starting to offer something a bit different. Finally, just always, there's more to learn, more to do. We want to continue to offer it. We want to extend the range of work placements. We're in talks with the SQE to see if there's something around this, that is this a real gap that could be developed into a qualification at SCQF level 5 with a wee bit of work. How do we take these young people and make sure that there is progression for them, that Sheena mentioned, into MEs or other? And we're looking at tying a lot of what you've heard already together in Dumfries and Galloway and saying, well, how do we start the promotion of this early on with young people in primary schools and in broad general education to raise awareness?